Welcome to week 10 of the Knowles Country ACC predictions and our first ever video blog. I'm your host and webmaster, Mike Crook. Well, technically this should have been our second posting, but we ran into some technical difficulties last week and couldn't get it published in time. There were some definite shakeups in the Coastal Division last week, and it's going to make for some fun finishes in both divisions as we head into the final month of our regular season. To kick things off this week, the ACC hosts another Thursday night contest between Virginia Tech and East Carolina. The Hokies are licking their wounds after losing two straight games to Coastal Division foes. And while East Carolina isn't exactly a juggernaut opponent, they won't be a pushover either. The Pirates are coming off back-to-back wins over Rice and Memphis and boast a 5-3 record on the season. This one also will not be held in Lane Stadium. I think the Hokies do rally and put together a convincing win. Kickoff is set for 7:30 p.m. Eastern Time on ESPN. On in the first round of Saturday games for November. Leading that lineup is Virginia at Miami. Virginia's coming off of a hard-fought loss to Duke last week, and Miami is lucky to come away with a win after Wake Forest blew a 13-point lead twice during that game. Both squads have two losses in the conference, and if they want to keep pace with Georgia Tech and Duke, then both of them need to win out. I'm going to have to go with the talent on the field and the coaching on the sidelines and pick Miami in this one. And I don't see them having to pull off another come-from-behind effort to seal a win either. Kickoff is set for noon Eastern on Raycom. Next up is Maryland at NC State. Maryland is coming off of a bye, and NC State is coming off of a heartbreaking loss to Florida State last week. With a combined conference record of 1-7 between these two teams, it's anyone's guess as to the outcome. But I think that Wilson will be able to guide the Wolfpack to their first ever conference win of the season and handle the Terps with ease. Kickoff is set for 1 p.m. Eastern Time on ESPN360.com. On to Atlanta, where Wake Forest comes to town after letting the game against Miami slip through their fingers. Make no mistake, though, the Deeks will be coming to play against the Yellow Jackets, and this one should be close for the first two, possibly three quarters, even if Riley Skinner doesn't play. But I see Georgia Tech pulling away from this one in the fourth and getting one game closer to locking up their Coastal Division title. Kickoff is set for 3:30 p.m. Eastern Time on either ABC or ESPN2. Check your local listings. Now we have what could be a huge dogfight in the state of North Carolina. Two basketball powerhouses will be squaring off on the gridiron this weekend, and one still has hopes of playing for the conference championship. And ironically, it's the Duke Blue Devils that control their own fate. Both Duke and UNC are coming off of impressive wins last week and are hoping to keep that momentum going. While most of the conference is rooting for Duke, both teams still need two wins just to be bowl eligible, and after this weekend, I'd see UNC as cutting that deficit to one. Their defense will shine again, and Yates will guide the offense and play smarter football. Kickoff is set for 3:30 p.m. Eastern Time on ESPNU. With Boston College having the weekend off, our final game is between Florida State and Clemson in Death Valley. Clemson is coming off of a scrimmage last weekend against Coastal Carolina, where their backups got loads of playing time, and Florida State is coming in after winning its second straight conference game, and second straight close win that required a game-winning fourth-quarter drive. FSU quarterback Christian Ponder did get banged up in that game, but is still expected to start for the Seminoles, where his experience and leadership will be needed against a much tougher defense. Clemson, however, could be without starting defensive back Daquan Bowers, who has a sprained MCL and PCL. This could bode well for FSU and their high-powered aerial attack. But will the Seminoles be able to contain C.J. Spiller? I picked the Noles to win this one in another close game and another great defensive stand at the end, especially after earlier today, defensive coordinator Mickey Andrews announced that he would be retiring at the end of the season. Kickoff is set for 7:45 p.m. Eastern Time on ESPN. The second half of the season has seen much improvement in my picks. 2 weeks ago, I went 4-2 with my only two losses coming to upset victories. The same goes for last weekend, where I posted a 6-1 record and my only loss coming from UNC's upset win. So here's hoping that the rest of the season can see improvement in my current 43-28 record. We'll see you back here next week, where we talk more ACC football with the final month of the regular season underway and potential ACC championship matchups. For KnowlesCountry.com, I'm Mike Crook.